Lucy, it's absolutely fantastic to have you with us at the MCM Comic Con. Have you been enjoying it today?
Do you know what? I've loved it. First time doing Birmingham NEC, so it's been really fabulous. It's been great meeting everybody. It's been busy. It's been very busy, so that's great.
The franchise Primeval, as it is now, massively successful all around the world. What do you think it was about it that specifically captured people's imagination so much?
I guess the CGI has a lot to do with it in terms of that. That really obviously starts to capture imagination. But I hope, one of the things I feel, is the characters and the chemistry between us all really kind of sparked. And I think people started to care about them as individuals as opposed to just part of a big kind of CGI extravaganza. So, I hope that's why. But yeah.
Talking about characters, you mentioned there, of course, your dual role. Can you talk about specifically the challenges and rewards of that kind of an endeavour?
Well, it's absolutely amazing to be in the same show and have the opportunity to have a go at two completely different women. I think the challenges were coming in season two and being somebody different, having had sort of a history of doing the show a year before. It was very hard to come in with people you know very well and pretend you don't know them, or even show that you have that kind of history with them. So that was difficult. But we worked on an incredibly different look for her initially in season two, which really helped. But yeah, I really enjoyed playing both of them. I know people have their favourites. And I struggled to actually know which one I prefer, but I really enjoyed playing them both. I liked playing Jenny's strength initially at the beginning, and I liked her journey because, of course, even though people feel very attached to Claudia Brown, which I find all the time, she was only in series one, and then I did the rest as Jenny. So Jenny sort of had more of a journey for me. She was very strong and quite sort of deliberate at the beginning, but then softened as she became more involved with the team, and I enjoyed playing that. And Claudia, I loved the romantic storyline with Douglas in that, and her vulnerability in the face of Helen Cutter. And that love triangle, I really enjoyed playing with Juliet and Douglas. So, yeah.
Apart from your own characters, fans, of course, have their favourites. Who are your favourite characters in the rest of the show? Who did you particularly enjoy working with or just watching when you saw the final product?
I mean, this sounds like I'm just being, you know, nice, but I actually really loved all the characters that came. And I thought Adrian Hodges is a fantastic writer, and they were all beautifully drawn. I think, obviously, Nick Cutter was an amazing character. He had so many different levels to him and lots to work with. I think because everyone was so different, they all brought sort of a different energy to the show, and that's why I couldn't really choose between them. I mean, these Hannah and Andrews were a fantastic little duo. James, Juliet was fabulous as Helen. Douglas was excellent at Nick. And our new character that came in, Layla, brought her own unique energy in. Ben Mansfield, fantastic as Becca. We were so lucky to have this amazing group of people all bringing their strengths to it, which I think made the show so popular. I think in season one, I loved the Tyrandon, which was the flying bird. And I also loved shooting that episode. It's one of my favourites. That's probably why I feel drawn to it. I loved the G-Rex in series three on the airfield. I thought that was great. It was so much fun to film that. The Future Predator, I thought, was an incredible creation who then, because of its success as a character, kept popping up all the way through. And yeah, I thought he was amazing. I mean, Framestore, who did all the special effects, we were brought in at the very beginning, before we even started shooting, and they showed us how they put these creatures together. And it was just phenomenal. So when the Future Predator arrived in front of us, we were like, you know, this is fabulous. This is going to be a success. This is great. So, yeah.
Particularly with some of the more CGI-heavy creations, were there ever any amusing moments on set where you're acting to the wrong tennis ball?
Or? Oh, geez. I have it all the time. Especially in season one, when we were all sort of novices with working this way. But there was a lot of funny moments in the show because there were, well, off camera, there were so many moments at the beginning, especially when we were all trying to find our way and we're all sort of looking in different places and all of that sort of stuff. But funny stories behind the scenes. I could write a book. Maybe I will. But I couldn't begin to like name them now. But yeah, there was lots. We had good fun. And I think maybe that's what came out through the show, is that behind the scenes, we all got on like a house on fire and we're having so much fun with each other. It kind of spilled through, I think, into the narrative. So yeah.
So what have you got coming up?
Well, actually, I've been writing over the past year, and I've just had a screenplay that I've co-written with an actress called Olivia Poulet, which has gone into pre-production, and we've just had Objective option a new TV series of ours, so that's what we're working on at the moment. And also, I've just done a film called This Is Vanity, which is now doing the festival circuit, and we've actually just found out we won Best Drama at the Magnolia Film Festival, so very, very excited to see how that continues through the festivals. So.
Congratulations on that. I mean, can you tell us anything more about that award-winning film project?
It was amazing. It was like the absolute polar opposite to Primeval. It was based on a true story of a woman many years ago now who lived in a council estate with her young autistic daughter who was bullied to the point of her getting in a car with her daughter and setting light to it. And that's what the film's about, and that's the character that I played. So it was a opportunity to completely transform and do some serious acting. And I'm absolutely thrilled with the way it's turned out. And I wish it well, as I said, through the festival circuit. We've already done a really strong start. So, hopefully that will be available to see in the very near future.
The TV series, is that something we're going to be able to see soon? And do you think it's going to appeal to Primeval fans? Or?
Well, I hope. You know, we've written a comedy. It's a comedy drama. And, who knows? I hope everybody enjoys it. We're in very early days with it. We're still writing it. But it's exciting. Exciting to be on that side of the table and watching something created that we've created from the ground up. So hopefully in the next year I can be able to go, here it is. But, yeah.
Do you have a message to Primeval fans watching this all over the world?
Oh, geez, no pressure. A message, well, I hope you continue to enjoy the show through the DVDs and the reruns that are constantly on. And thank you so much for supporting us for the past 5 years.